the practice that we use, we only include those pipeline developments that have been approved. And again, I'm going to pass the buck here and say, you know, DDOT does have to approve the study, and they do have to agree with us.
We can all stick our heads in and...
But...
Listen, let's get to the next substantive point, because other people have their hands on it.
Can you go to the picture of the alley?
The vehicular circulation slide?
Yeah, yeah, right. As you move from south to north, it's sort of the north end of that alley, is another alley that goes east and west. Is that, what's going to happen to that alley? Can your trucks go up and down that alley? Can your cars...
Can you tell me, like, when to stop moving my...
Right there.
Right in the peak.
Right there.
I didn't even know that alley was there.
There are row houses on Chesapeake Street. We just talked about backyards and garages, they're all on there.
Your worry is that there'll be traffic for their building?
Well, I don't know. I mean, they haven't studied it. They haven't told us whether that's going to be impacted by their site or not.
So...
Seems to be a reasonable question that residents would have, but...
So you're worried about traffic, both trucks and vehicles, using this alley here to get to the site?
We'll look at it.
Okay, so that's, they'll do...
It's a good question, we'll look at it.
Okay. Is there any other discreet point, because there's a few people with hands up, and then we want to get out by 11 o'clock and let you guys all out.
Fair enough. The only other comment I would make on your traffic management plan is, we'll give people a lot of information and hope for the best. We sort of said this at the beginning. And you don't, and that's just your residents, you've not said anything about what restrictions are the truckers going to have when they come into our neighborhood. Can they drive in the alley? Can they drive down Chesapeake Street, Ellicott Street, Festival Street?
So you'd like us to look at a loading management plan? That's certainly something we can look at. It's fairly common.
And how are you going to force that with your big, you know, trucks coming in?
Yeah, that's something you've heard through the evening that people are concerned about. Okay, let me...
The same with retail people.
It's a really good comment.
So let me move on. So I have two questions over here, but I said Aaron is going to be next, and then I think probably you two are going to be the last, and then we'll give the commissioners a chance to speak. So Aaron?
Thanks, I appreciate it. So my name is Aaron Berman. Ben next to me is also in our group from Revive 3E. If you don't know what that is, it's a group of about 40 residents in our ANC who supports projects that'll add nice restaurants, retail, and nice public spaces in our area. I just wanted to make a brief kind of 20,000 foot statement on all of this stuff, so appreciate the time. One thing I should mention about our group is that many of us are working parents with young children who don't have a lot of time for neighborhood meetings. So looking around me, I'm guessing my viewpoint might be in the minority in this room, but I don't think it's as in the minority in the community in general. And in fact, one of our members lives within 200 feet of this project and is listed on the PUD. In general, we're very supportive of this project. I want to note that I've already heard some people mentioning issues about building height. We've had a lot of detailed discussion about traffic. I think it's great that we have these community discussions, that the developers take these issues into account, and we can encourage that. I do want to encourage the commissioners not to fall into the trap of seeking to reduce the height of the buildings by a significant degree, or doing such extensive work on the traffic mitigation plan that it undermines the viability of the project. And this project and projects like it are really what's going to add, be able to economically attract the retail and restaurants that we want on the corridor. So we just wanted to put that out there in general. Again, with all of these continuing discussions, I think it's great that we get the community input and if you guys respond with it, we make tweaks as needed. I also wanted to say that if anyone else agrees with us in terms of this general theory and general framework, you can find us Revive 3E on Facebook, Revive the number 3, the letter E. We'll put information out there about how you can make your opinion known.
Aaron, how would you feel if you lived in behind that building?
I would absolutely welcome it because I live right next to the Lord and Taylor in Friendship Heights, and I would love it if someone destroyed that horrible parking lot and built up a large but with smart setbacks and smart traffic mitigation plans.
And if you think for buildings.
All right, okay. Now we got to go. Also, that's why, you know, lawyers never ask a question they don't know the answer to.
Thanks very much. Appreciate it.
No, well, they're supposed to not during cross-examination. So we had you, and then I think we'll give the commissioners a chance and try to wrap up.
One question, but before my question, I appreciate restaurants and public space too, but this doesn't really, I mean, public space is a small amount. Might not even be public, might be the restaurant might lease it. A quote-unquote restaurant, we don't know what kind of restaurant. But anyway, and I think the height density is very, very high and out of proportion to the other buildings in the neighborhood. But my question is not transportation, it's about the impact on the public schools and the junior high schools. These would be one-bedroom, two-bedroom, three-bedroom units, and families, I assume, will be moving in. Has anybody studied the impact on whether the public school system can incorporate, can, you know, all these maybe new kids who are coming, who will be attending those schools?
So this project is a little bit too small to look at something that large. I'm not sure what DDOT has done in terms of long-term planning or what any other DC groups have done.
Why don't you just talk to me about the units?
I'm not sure. But I could look into
that. Are these one-bedroom, two-bedroom, three-bedroom units? What's the percentage?
There'll be a mix of studios, one-bedrooms, one-bedroom plus den, and two-bedroom. I don't have the exact unit mix with me. I would probably say that more than half of the units in the building are studios and one-bedrooms, but there will be some two-bedrooms in the building, and it's hard to predict, but there might be some, you know, couples with young children. I think as children reach sort of more of a school age, this might not be, might be a little cramped for them to live here, but I don't know. We're certainly a child-friendly building.
Which is great, I think. I just want to know if anybody studied the impact of all the influx of perhaps new kids, I mean, new attendees.
And that's another good piece of information that we should probably post to the website is the unit mix, because we get asked that question a lot and it's just hard to remember it. We'll put that up there.
Okay, and then all right, John, I'm going to let this lady, John, you can be the last if it's brief.
Very brief.
Okay, so I'm going to go to you and then you and then the commissioners.
I'm opposed.
Oh, I'm sorry. Have you had your hand up for a while?
No, I just wanted to be in the lineup.
All right. If it's very brief, we'll get you. Okay. No more after that, just because the commissioners want to have a few minutes, and then we do want to get everybody out by 11 if we can.
Okay. I would like to say I'm opposed to the loosening of the comprehensive plan that was approved since 1988, I believe.
Well, there was a new one in 2006.
Whatever. 2006. And I think this is exceeding what I would feel comfortable with by at least one floor and probably two.
So let me get the woman over there, and then you have a brief comment, John Wheeler gets a brief comment, and then we're going to close it for tonight. You guys are going to be back. And actually, just before you, when do you anticipate a hearing on the merits?
So, I mean, I think we're likely set down maybe in January.
That's set down.
The hearing, best case, March, more likely maybe April.
Okay.
I mean, so we're looking at a spring hearing.
If we want to, there's time for you to be back here before we have our final meeting and vote. So.
Absolutely.
Okay. Ma'am.
Please look forward to it.
I always enjoy these meetings.
Yes.
Yeah.
Ma'am.
I live a few blocks from this site. And through the years, I've been sort of on the edge of discussions about the GDS development, and that's sort of on hold now. But to see this new development proposed at an extreme higher than what was going to happen on the GDS site, it just seems, here we go again, but we're talking about even greater heights and even greater density. So I just want to be in the camp of people who are concerned about the height and the density.
So John.
I just have a comment. All this discussion about traffic generation, and it's going to be a reduction in traffic, so I don't even understand how you can discuss adverse traffic impact when there's a reduction in traffic. I mean, you may, and that seems pretty logical, that if you go from a office building to a residential building, there's going to be a reduction in traffic. So that's just a statement. You know, we're talking about the traffic here, there, and everywhere, and I just can't see it.
I mean, logically, just to answer, it depends on where the traffic, the kind of traffic and where it's coming from.
Right,
so if they're all going by where there's more, now there are more pedestrians, for instance.
You would think if it's an office building, also the traffic is going to be much closer in time.
It could be.
These buildings are vacant for many years.
Yeah, I know.
And they're very small, and they're not having people in them.
Anyway, I take your point, and I know Brooke mentioned it too. But everything depends on the facts. You're right. There's talking about reduction. Okay, so.